Welcome to working in the Moodle template for online courses. The purpose of this video is to introduce the Moodle template designed by the LSU Online team and show how you can customize the template for your own courses. In this video, we will be working in the campus Moodle template, which is different from the template used for fully online courses and programs offered by LSU Online. By the end of this video, you should be able to navigate through the template and edit the template in Moodle. This is not meant to be a Moodle workshop, so we won't have time to go into detail about each Moodle component. Instead, this video will help you become familiar with the template layout and get some experience with editing sections of the template. During the video, we'll briefly discuss the benefits and purpose of the Moodle template and give a tour of a course that has been designed using the template. We'll also highlight some of the specific features of the template, such as the module structure, and the template's impact on content presentation and organization. In the second half of this video, we will focus on how you can edit and work in the template. Throughout the video, I encourage you to pause and practice the on-screen prompts in your own Moodle course. If you would like to request a copy of the template, please visit our website. Click on Course Design and Development, and then Working in the Moodle Template. So let's get started. The Moodle template was created to provide faculty a framework or foundation that they can use as they're developing or building blended or online courses. The template is designed to be student-centered, accessible, and consistent. For example, the inclusion of student-facing language helps students feel connected to the learning experience. The template also increases the accessibility and usability of the course by improving course navigation and organization. You'll notice that the consistent module format aids students in easily locating information throughout the course. The layout helps students know what to expect, not only within the course, but across courses in their program. Lastly, instructional language has been incorporated throughout the template to aid faculty in sharing instructional material, activities, and assessments that are clear, consistent, and aligned to course outcomes. A module can be thought of as an instructional or learning unit within a course. The essential course design elements provide a suggested layout for a module, but it is not required that you follow this layout exactly. The activities and resources included within this layout are examples of what you can create in your online or blended course. The elements present the content in a logical learning path that allows students to get the most out of the content and activities. The top section of the module serves as an advanced organizer, including a relevant image that is tied to the module topic, a written or video description of what the module will cover, the presentation of the related learning objectives or course outcomes, and a list of tasks for achieving these outcomes, presented in the suggested order of completion. Following this section, module resources are presented in a Moodle book resource. The book resource can include the instructional content that you want to provide your students, in addition to any outside readings. In other words, students would complete the assigned reading within the textbook as mentioned in this list above, and then they would come here and click on each chapter to find instructional text, videos, images, or other supporting materials that you'd like for them to have. Below the resources are the module learning activities and assessments that provide guided practice for the summative assessments. The activities included within the template are suggestions which can be tailored based on the nature of your course and the desired course outcomes. Activities and assessments might include auto-graded activities such as the Moodle quiz or lesson, or a Moodle discussion forum to foster interaction between students and critical thinking about the concepts covered within the module. Let's take a look at a course that was developed using the Moodle template for online courses. The image at the top of the course is customizable and helps add color and interest to your course. The course contents on the left margin allow students and faculty to easily navigate between modules. This navigation reduces the amount of scrolling necessary to access the course materials, which can be difficult and frustrating for some users. Click on any module title to directly navigate to those materials. The Course Tools dashboard is where you can access a quick link to the gradebook, students enrolled in the course, and your Kaltura media. Let's go back to the main page and take a closer look at the course contents. The Welcome module is the first module in the course contents. This module provides easy access to the course and instructor information. Information regarding instructor office hours is also included in this module. Maintaining virtual office hours encourages meaningful interaction between instructors and students. The Getting Started module provides students a clear starting point in the course. The News and Announcements forum is one way to share timely updates with your students. This module also includes one of the most important course documents, the course syllabus. A syllabus template has been provided for you to download and customize. Although you may already have a syllabus prepared, it may be helpful to add your information to the syllabus template provided here, as the template has been formatted to meet accessibility guidelines and provide sample language that may be useful for your students. Getting Started also includes an introductory or icebreaker activity and Q&A forums for your students. These forums help create community in your online course and can promote student engagement. The For Instructors module includes best practices for using the template and important information about regulatory requirements in online courses. This module is for you to refer to should you need it, and it should remain hidden from students. If the module is not currently hidden, or if you would like to ensure that it is hidden, click on the For Instructors module in the table of contents and look for the Hide Show icon near the upper center of your screen. If the icon has a slash through it, it is hidden from students. To hide it, you can click the icon. As we move past the two introductory modules, you will notice that the content is in the center of the screen and organized according to the essential course design elements that we looked at earlier. In this example, you can see how the layout of the course design elements translates to a course. The top section includes the module title, an image, an introduction, course outcomes, and the checklist. Required or supplemental resources, such as videos, images, links to websites or articles, or texts written by the instructor, can be organized using the Moodle book or page resources. For example, if I click here, you can see that there is an embedded video with a transcript and a short description. Below the resources are the module activities, which include formative assessments and opportunities for peer-to-peer interaction. For students, there are a few features that make this Moodle theme or interface more user-friendly. One of them is a progress tracker that shows the number of activities in a module and how many activities the student has completed. Students can also see whether they have attempted or completed an activity. Here is what you can expect to see in the template before content is added. Boilerplate language is included in black. Suggestions for presenting content are also included in red brackets. The included activities utilize settings based on best practices of online course design, but should be customized to meet your needs. Now let's dive into editing and customizing a blank Moodle template. When you receive a copy of the template, it will look similar to this. Locate the table of contents in the left side navigation bar of your course. Recall that the For Instructors module should be hidden from your students. The Welcome module is the first module. The instructions in red brackets are intended for your customization. There may also be placeholders for certain items throughout the template, such as the image placeholder you see here. To customize this upper section of the Welcome module, select the icon labeled Edit Section. Once you are on the editing page, you can customize the text. Pause the video at any time to practice the following steps. First, update your course name in the first line by erasing the red text and entering your course name. There is an icon in the editing toolbar which can help you quickly clear the formatting of the red text. First, you will need to expand the editing toolbar by selecting the very first icon labeled Show Advanced Toolbar. Then, locate the cursor icon labeled Clear Formatting. To use the feature, highlight the text you wish to unformat and select the Clear Formatting icon. Enter a course introduction here. Consider recording and embedding a Kaltura video. Once you have added a text or video introduction, delete the red text. Use the Clear Formatting tool if needed to clear the red font and ensure consistent text throughout your course. When satisfied, choose Save Changes. The About Your Instructor section is a Moodle page resource. Let's add your picture and information to the page. Choose the pencil icon labeled Edit beneath the image placeholder. Update the description by entering your name. It is recommended that you edit the image placeholder rather than delete and replace due to special formatting that has been provided for you through the placeholder. To edit this placeholder with your own image, double-click the image and choose Browse Repositories. You can upload an image of yourself from your computer or from a cloud storage service if you use one. Add alternative text and adjust the image size from this screen as well. You should always include alternative text for any meaningful images included in your course so that they are accessible. When satisfied, click the Save Image button. Include a brief instructor introduction in the form of text or a video. When done, delete the notes in red and choose Save and Return to Course. The Office Hours information page can be edited in the same way. Choose the pencil icon below Read More. Read the recommendations provided to you and customize the text with your own information. Update your email address by highlighting the placeholder text and inputting your address. Create a direct link to open an email message addressed to you by highlighting your email address, clicking on the link icon in the editing toolbar, and typing mail2: your email address, all one word, within the hyperlink field. Finish by clicking Create Link. In the Getting Started module, a syllabus template has been provided for you to download and customize. Download the syllabus template by clicking the link. When you are ready to upload your syllabus, you may drag and drop the file into the module, or upload the file by choosing Create a Learning Activity and choosing File under the Resources tab. Once you are satisfied with your syllabus, delete the instructional label by clicking on the three dots and choosing Delete. Finally, customize the Introduce Yourself and Q&A forums in this module. Click the pencil icon to edit the forum description and instructions. If you have questions about using the Moodle activities, such as the discussion forums, contact the Faculty Technology Center. Once you are done, click Save Changes. The content in Module 1 can be edited in the same way that we have edited components in the previous modules. Add a corresponding module image in Introduction by clicking Edit Section. Double-click the image placeholder and locate the image on your computer or cloud storage service. Replace the placeholder text with a short introduction. Use the Clear Formatting tool if needed. Click the pencil icon to add your learning objectives or course outcomes and list of module activities. If copying your outcomes from another document and pasting into Moodle, it is recommended that you paste this unformatted text and reformat the numbered list using the icon in the toolbar. Include a list of all activities that students should complete in this module, including required readings or activities that may occur outside of Moodle. Utilize the ordered list icon and the clear formatting icon in the editing toolbar. Save changes when complete. The page labeled For Instructors includes additional information for you regarding Moodle resources and activities. It may be helpful to hide rather than delete the page so that you can refer back to this information as you are developing your course. Click on the three dots and choose Hide. You can choose to delete the page from this menu as well. As shown in part 1 of this video, each module also includes suggested activities and resources that can be customized to your needs. The pre-populated activities and resources are suggested to provide students a clear and engaging learning path. However, if you would like to remove an activity or resource from a module, you can do so by choosing the More icon and selecting Delete. If you would like to add additional activities or resources to any module, scroll to the bottom of the module and click on Create Learning Activity. Once you have finished developing your course with the Template Master Course, be sure to create a backup and import it into your teaching course once it is ready. This concludes our Moodle Template for Online Courses video. For more information on the topics covered in this video, visit grok.lsu.edu. If you have any Moodle or technology-related questions or would like assistance, please contact the Faculty Technology Center at 225-578-3375 option 2 or FTC at lsu.edu.